Alright, so here we are, guys. This will be it. This is going to be the last match between these two players. Okay, so spawning here up at the top right, representing, of course, Team Grubby himself. It is going to be the green Protoss player, Grubby. The Grubbinator. His opponent is spawning at the left, representing Global Esports Management Group, playing from Dusseldorf, Germany. It is going to be the red Protoss player, Minchel, MC. Boss Toss. President. Toss. Was it? Boss Toss. President Toss. I can't remember. We've come up. Suicide Toss is really old school ID, if anyone remembers that. But yeah, okay, so we have merry-go-round. A three-player map. They're not going to know where each other spawns, but of course, you know, that doesn't mean that they won't be that aggressive. It's, you know, it's only three players. It's not that big of a scout. Proxies can be quite popular. Proxy Oracle. Gateway timing is just a couple seconds ahead for Minchel. So he's looking pretty good. Oh, lag. A little bit like that. Nothing too big. Probably just a battle in the server, but gas number one being taken. Gas number two has actually been delayed here by Grubby. A little bit moment. Okay, not that much. Okay. And yeah, so this is a map where blink is actually quite potent. The ramp is quite large into the natural. You can blink into the main and, you know, fight from this area. So that's very good. DTs, of course. DTs are popular on every map. And the other one is, of course, Stargate. Now, Phoenix Oracle, that's whatever. Like, if anyone's wondering, like, Robo is not a build anymore. It's just not something that you do. The only way it would probably be viable is maybe if you went for a, like, two-gate Nexus Robo. Or a Robo into a Nexus, or Nexus Robo. But Nexus Robo is very, very risky. Okay, so of course, finishing up. Ooh, and a sentry straight away here for Grubby. Another pylon gets added on the sentry. The worker will run away just before the sentry does pop, so he knows it's not a sentry. If he saw that, that would change his game plan. And do we have three pylons? Okay, there's the third pylon from C. Alright. So it should be some sort of an expansion build, but Grubby did go for a Twilight for the sentry last game. They did both expand overall, so I'm expecting some Stargate. No, oh, two, three. There's a quota boost. What's the timing? It's pretty good. Probes coming down here, mothership is coming down here. Grubby hasn't even scouted yet. Phoenix, hallucinated Phoenix won't be available for about another, like, 40 seconds. And the probe does get picked off over here. So Grubby knows where his opponent is. There's a pylon being added on. Minchel's going up to three gateways. And that is it, guys. So it looks like a bit of three gate aggression with a 2-on-2 there. So he, you know, he doesn't have that much gas either. So if something happened and, you know, he needed to drop some tech like a Twilight, he's gonna be a little bit limited. This probe is gonna go around the side. It's not gonna get scouted. Okay, and that. Yeah, we have a robot now for Grubby. Grubby does have to be very careful. This sentry needs to nail that force field. He has to react straight away. He does get it. He does have another force field available. Warp gate is soon to finish up, and gateways are finishing as well. So he has three gates and a robo. There's another force field. The warp bins are going to be here, maybe just in the nick of time. The probe did get picked off, and there is no more pylon. This is so big. The warping has to come in right now. Is he? He's gotta get up here. And oh, that was so close. It looks like Grubby might be able to just about hold. It all depends on the next few warpins. MC's adding on nothing behind this. Another sentry gets warped in. A force field can be added if he goes for it. Oh my god, the sentry gets picked off. And that force field will expire in a moment's time. There is no mothership core. with a Photon Overcharge, it did have to recall, I believe. And it looks like Minchil will be able to maybe just about push this. Nice micro coming out of him. Target firing the Stalker's got to be careful. He doesn't get surrounded. And Grubby is dropping in supply. He's at 23 v21 workers. His army supply is doubled right now. And I don't see Grubby holding this. Mothership go still so low on energy. It's 64. So that, you know, the 64 is about another 70 seconds left on for that energy. And pylons getting picked off soon to be depowering. And Blink has finished. So the micro of Grubby has to be absolutely spectacular if he wants to hold this on. But, you know, 10 Stalkers v4 Mothership Core. And a Photon Overcharge still not available. There's the Sentry. As Alok getting whooped in. Time Warp doesn't do much against Blink. But that is going to be GG. MC, nice build coming out of MC. Just unfortunate there for Grubby, just missing his force fields. The sentry did get picked off. There's another blink forward. This will be the last stand. The Photon Overcharge gets deployed. 6 workers, V20. There's 5, there's 4, there's 3, and that will be the last one.